Start the solution. First of all, we assume that E1 be the event of drawing a ball from box 1. E2 be the event of drawing a ball from box 2. E be the event of drawing a defective ball. Now we will find out the probability of E1. Here E1 and E2 are the probability or event of draw the ball from the box 1 and box 2. So here two box are given, and therefore the total number of possible cases equal to 2, and the cases that will be favorable to occurring of the E1 will be 1. Therefore the value will be 1/2. Since P E1 equal to 1/2, therefore P E2 will be 1/2. We have already find out these two value. Now we will find out the probability of drawing a ball from the box 1, and it is found to be defective because the question is given at the box is selected at random and then one ball is drawn at random from the box. Therefore we will find out the probability of drawing a ball from the box 1, and it is found to be defective. And it is a conditional probability which can be written down PE/E1. In conditional probability, the value or the event which is written in the right hand side is the event which occurred first, and the event which is written down in the left hand side is occurred after the event in the right hand side. So here E1, the event occurred first, after that depending on E1 the next event E occurred. So E1 is the event of drawing the box 1, E is the event of drawing a defective ball. Therefore the conditional probability PE/E1 will be probability of drawing a ball from box 1 and found to be defective. In the box 1 contain 3 defective ball and 7 non-defective ball. Therefore total number of ball equal to 3 plus 7 equal to 10, and number of defective ball equal to 3. So here we have draw one ball. We can write down 10 C1, total number of ball is equal to 10. Out of 10 ball we have to draw one ball, and there are 3 defective ball, so we can write down 3 C1. We know that NC1 value equal to N, so 3C1 value will be 3. That means N value is replaced by 3. So 3C1 equal to 3. 10C1 value equal to 10. We can write down 3 divided by 10. One conditional probability we have find out. Then another conditional probability will be PE/E2. That means here E2 event occurred first, and depending on E2 the next event E occurred. E2 is the event of drawing a ball from the box 2. So here first of all we draw the ball from the box 2, and it is found to be defective. So write down probability of drawing a ball from box 2 and found to be defective. In the box 2, one defective ball and 9 non-defective ball are present. Therefore, total number of ball is equal to 1 plus 9 equal to 10. Number of defective ball equal to 1. So, out of 10 ball, we are to choose 1 defective ball. Here, total number of possible cases will be 10C1. And there is only 1 ball present. So, we can write down 1C1. So, we know that NC1 value equal to N. 1C1 value will be 1, 10C1 value will be 10. Write down 1 divided by 10. In the question, find out the probability box 1 is chosen given a defective ball is drawn. Therefore, probability that box 1 is chosen given a defective ball is drawn. Here again it is a conditional probability. Now box 1 is chosen first, so this is the first event, and the probability of choosing the first box given a defective ball is drawn. So here defective ball is drawn first. After that we came to know that box 1 is chosen. So we can write down E1 by E. So defective ball is chosen first. After that we came to know that it is from the box 1. Here from the Bayes theorem we can write down PE1 into PE by E1 divided by PE1 into PE by E1 plus PE2 into probability of PE by E2, and this is by Bayes theorem. Here replace all the value PE1, it is 1 by 2 into 3 divided by 10 and 1 by 2 into 3 divided by 10 plus 1 by 2 into 1 by 10. Here we can take the LCM 2 into 10 both for the numerator and denominator. So 3 divided by 2 into 10. And here LCM 2 into 10, 3 into 1, 3, 1 into 1, 1. 2 cancel out, 10 cancel out. Value 3 divided by 3 plus 1, that means 3 divided by 4.